Asking our callers today if you could write your own immigration policy for for your country or for another country, what kind of immigration rules do you think would be fair? Now, of course, with Indonesia, we know from the news you have the issue with Australia sending people, migrants back. And I know there's a lot of debate and dispute between Indonesia and Australia over immigration policy. So, what are your thoughts?
I want to go abroad. Yes, to Australia. I want to be a worker there. But no, I have been preparing my English. Yeah, I think it's my English is not good, right?
Well, no,
No,
it's
it's
very
fine.
good. So, what are you do? Are you seeking the right to travel legally to Australia? I mean, is that the route you and you're thinking of doing this, legally applying for a right to travel and live in Australia?
I'm so sorry, but a little bit understand what's your
That's
question, like
okay.
what's your question?
If you go to Australia, how will you go? Will you go legally with a visa? Will you go another way?
Oh yes, no. Actually, no. I have been looking for someone that recommend me. And what should I do there? And what job is suit for me? For instance, be a worker in a restaurant. And now I'm blind and don't know what to do because I have no experience go abroad.
Have you I mean, is this idea of, I know some people try to get there illegally. They get on a boat, they pay someone to try to
No, no,
smuggle
no,
them
no.
in. You would not you would
No.
you're not thinking of the being the going the
No.
route of smuggling or trafficking.
Yes, I use the passport maybe to immigration, and I maybe get permit from Australia Embassy, like
For
that. Things like.
the Indonesians who cannot get a passport from the embassy and they choose to go to Australia on a boat, how should they be treated when they get to Australia?
You mean go Australia by boat?
If a person goes by boat and lands in Australia illegally, how should Australia treat that person? What should they do with that person? What do you think?
That's an illegal person. I think the Australian government first must take an action. Are they terrorists? Are they how to say that criminal, right? Crime person or so also Indonesia about 2 months ago they were immigrant from Myanmar. And
I
now
knew
in
that.
Myanmar, they are in war, right? And they were thrown away by their own government. And the Myanmar person, they arrived in our city, Aceh province, Indonesia. But our society and our government received them. Well, and our society treat them well and give food and something like the dress and etc.
Today we are talking about immigration, and Afghanistan, of course, has had years of conflict, years of war, and many people have moved around the country and also out of the country. And so we're getting ideas from people about what laws or policies should help govern the movement of people inside a country.
As I have seen in the countries, it is a trend of all developing countries about external immigration. That all the developing countries, especially Asian and African countries, people are willing to move to U.S. or European countries. And inside the country, the most of the people, especially in Afghanistan, all the people are trying to move from the provinces to Kabul, because in here is the capital, the employment situation is good in here, the education, the schools, and other opportunities that have the center. The capital, it's not in the provinces, especially in Afghanistan. So the people are just always trying, and it's clear that now in Kabul, 6 million people are living in Kabul.
Wow.
Although that Kabul is just on the Kabul, when Kabul was built, it was for only for 50,000 people. But now, unfortunately, in here, it is a big problem, the rush of the population in Kabul.
There must be a lot of stress on the people and the services and transportation.
Yeah, it's clear that the problem with the transportation, with the you say the trust, because different kinds of people are living in here. And there is lots of people that are not like, aware of the city culture. I mean, when they are coming from the rural areas, so they are not ready to live in a city. So they are trying, they are misusing from the countries, from the cities.
Well,
opportunities.
So actually getting back to Kate's original question, which was about when you said about rules governing movements within a country. So what about, are there policies from the Kabul government? I mean, can anyone move to the capital, or are there policies that are trying to, help improve development outside Kabul so fewer people will want to migrate? What's the situation?
Yeah, no, unfortunately, still the government is very busy for securing, ensuring security. So they haven't thought about this problem.
If you were a government advisor, what would you suggest they do to help support all those 6 million people that you were talking about?
I think the security problem is the most important phenomenon in Kabul, in Afghanistan, because except Kabul and maybe two provinces that are Herat and Mazar, from 30 provinces are insecure, not secure, and the people are the reason that people are willing to leave their province, their real their places, homes, and come to the capital is security. You know that in the northern and southern provinces of Afghanistan, they don't let the girls to go to the school. They are burning the schools, and the people cannot study. Also, there is not university, and as well as jobs and employments. So the people are. I think the first reason, the first work that should be done to make people to go back to the provinces is ensuring of security. Up to that time that we couldn't, up to that time that the provinces are not secure, so the people will not move back to the provinces. And after, when the security ensured, I'm sure that after ensuring security, the schools will be open, the people, the projects, the development projects will be start on the provinces, and employment will be available on there. In this time, there are lots of projects that are stopped because of insecurity.
I am a monk, a Buddhist monk from Vietnam. I come from Vietnam, but right now I'm in Thailand. I'm going to study here for 4 years.
You are going to study in Thailand for 4 years?
Yes.
So how is the adjustment? How are you adjusting to a different country and different people?
Yeah, it's fantastic. Do you want to come here? Everything here is different with Vietnam. It's so hard for the first time, but now it's okay.
You said it was hard in the first time. What was difficult?
Yeah, it's so difficult for me about language. In Thailand, the first difficulty is the English, the language. And the second difficulty for me is the food. It's so hard for me. I come from Vietnam. In Vietnam, the Buddhism in Vietnam is Mahayana. And the monk in Vietnam, we eat only vegetable and vegetarian food. No meat, no fish. Yeah. But in Thailand, it's Theravada Buddhism. The monk in Thailand, every morning, they go on fruits, collect fruits, and the people will give the monk fruits, everything they give, maybe meat, fish, rice, milk, everything. And the monk in Thailand, they can eat everything, but they never eat afternoon. Only one or two meals a day for breakfast and for lunch, never have a dinner. It's for me, I can have two meals a day, okay, but it's so hard for me to eat meat or fish. So there's a different culture and it's so hard for me.
I'm a student, I'm in the high school.
What kind of laws do you think would be fair? Should people be allowed to move wherever they wish? Should governments have greater control over borders? What are your thoughts?
I think for studies, to go abroad to study in order to study and to learn more.
So you would make laws to help students go abroad to study.
That's it.
So right now in your country, are students not allowed to go abroad and study?
Or is it not easy for them to go abroad?
Yes, they are allowed, but not everybody, not all students are allowed to go abroad to study. You know, not they can go, but for conditions, there are conditions which like obstacles which don't allow them to go abroad to study.
What kind of obstacles or conditions?
For example, the main obstacle is the money, and after we have a lot of things such, I don't know, papers and, you know, something like this.
If you were king of your own country and you could write immigration laws, what kind of laws do you think would be fair?
No, it's difficult to say for me, but I think it's your American right to immigration. It's very polite to my mind. And I think your right to immigration as to country that for all our the world, it's more politely and it's more welcome, because you America for all the world and for Russian people, I think it's like a symbol of freedom.